So I've been in the industry for 10 years. I started my journey working with the data. So right from collecting the data to data warehousing and then building data lakes and now to analyzing it, visualizing it. So I've been through the entire pipeline of the data. My talk is about an algorithm that helps detect yaw misalignments in a wind turbine. So as we all know, with this climate change, how important is renewable energy becoming in the current world? So the algorithm talks about a particular problem in a wind turbine called yaw misalignment, which causes the generation from the wind turbine to come down and also affects the structural integrity of the turbine. So this is an algorithm that helps identify that problem and also recommend the corrective action for it. So people have started talking more about deep learning than ever before, and it's coming into a lot of varied fields. Like today in our organization, we are working with a problem of implementing how the effectiveness of the blades, like, you know, if there are any defects with the blades using deep learning. So it's permeated into a lot of fields where it was never even talked about before. So I think that's... So firstly, there are a lot of companies that are looking at implementing cybersecurity. So places where there is a lot of data, there is also a lot of vulnerability that they will face. And hence, a lot of companies are looking for securing their data. And that is where the cybersecurity is increasing. And with wherever there's a lot of data, there is ML. So, and now there are a lot of universities that are coming up with courses that are specific to blending these two technologies. So, just to tell you a fact, in my organization, it's the other way around. So we have more women in the team than men. And just to say how to bring that gender equality, I think a lot of organizations are trying towards it. So that is a very cognitive decision that needs to be taken while the data collection itself. So that it came into limelight because it was related to humans, but that happens with every place that the data is collected. So even with the turbine data that we work with, there is a lot of biased data. So that needs to be a cognitive decision right at the data collection point itself about how to ensure that such biases do not creep into the data. Curious.